Hello students, Sai Ram. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 9 of your NCERT science textbook, and the title of this chapter is Living Organisms, Characteristics and Habitats, part 1. And this chapter, children, this chapter is more related to the nature and the way of life. This chapter is going to be very interesting. So let us begin with today's class. The living organisms and its characteristics. Though the title mentioned the living organisms, we cannot separate non-living things from the life. You might have heard of biotic and abiotic components. Biotics means, yes, living organisms, living things. Abiotic means non-living components. But both biotic and abiotic together makes the planet Earth. The place at which a living organism lives, that means habitat of a living organism, is dependent on its characteristic, and the characteristic of a living being depends upon its habitat. The word habitat means the natural environment of an organism where it lives. It is the type of place in which it is natural for organisms to live and grow. That place is known as the natural habitat of that living place. Let's begin today's chapter with a brief introduction for this chapter. Let us all have a questionnaire for ourselves. You have to answer this question to yourself only, so that we can recall all the knowledge that we have about various types of living and non-living objects. My first question is, have you ever been to a new place on your work vacation? Yes, most of us like hill station, which are far away from cities, noise and pollution. We visit to such places to spend some time close to the nature, right? Yes. What do we see in hill stations? We see hills, mountains, rivers, and we enjoy the climate, food over there, etc. What is the climatic condition of the hill station there, children? It is very cold at such places. And what kind of trees do you see there? The exclusive type of trees we find growing in such places. Or in the hill station, we see the trees like oaks, pine tree, devdar trees, etc. It feels good when we imagine or visit such places. Isn't it, student? Yes, we all love to visit or just if we imagine that we are in the hill station, we feel very happy. My next question is, have you ever visited to a desert? Or have any idea how our desert conditions are? In India, we have desert region in Rajasthan state. What is the most peculiar animal we find there? Yes, it is camel. What are the weather conditions of the desert? Yes, it is very hot there. We barely find any plants growing in desert because in desert region, availability of water is very less. And the type of plants we find in desert region are cactus plants, which are very thick, hard and thorny. And there are many types of places we visit to explore the nature. Yes, while recollecting all the types of places we have visited, don't you ever wonder that each of them are very different from each other? Some places are so cold, some are very hot, some are very dry, and some places are so humid. But each one have many kinds of living organisms growing in that particular place. Students, can you find a place on Earth where there may not be any living creature present? Try to find out a place inside your house, in your cupboards, outside your homes, whenever you see, you could not think of any living creatures that is not present there. Even the minute tiny germs are also the living creatures which are present everywhere. The planet Earth has many millions and billions of living creatures, of which many of them are known and many are yet to be known. Let me share with you an amazing interesting fact, students. Did you know, even near the volcanic openings, people have found tiny living organisms present there and growing there? That means that is their habitat. Proceeding into the chapter, next we are going to recall and learn more about organisms and their surroundings where they live in. That is nothing but living organisms and their habitat. Next is, what are the kinds of living organisms that are present in different locations? Yes, children, you have to answer this to yourself. In desert, we see camels, and at mountains, we see goats and yaks. And at the beaches, we see a variety of fish being caught by fishermen in the sea, and we find some creatures like plants that are present in all of these different locations. Study about the component of habitat. Any habitat, terrestrial or aquatic, is made up of living and non-living things. A living being in habitat, that is plants, animals, microorganisms, make biotic components of habitat. The non-living things like air, water, soil, light, temperature constitute abiotic components of habitat. Living things such as plants, animals and microorganisms are the biotic components of habitat. So we can say that habitat include both living and non-living things around and organisms. Living things such as plants, animals and microorganisms are biotic components, whereas non-living things such as air, water, soil, rocks, sunlight, temperature are the non-living thing are the abiotic components of the habitat. And children, I am ending this session over here. In next session, we will study about the types of habitat where organism lives. So children, here I am ending this session. Goodbye children, take care.